All right, guys, welcome to episode 7. I think it's episode 7 of the Mazda restoration. Hi, Nick.
Hello.
Hi, guys. Okay, we have the Mazda again inside, and just a quick recap. In the last episode, we finished here the front end, and it is now complete. There's a few little things that we're gonna have to do here. Also, there's some bracket here that we are missing. We have to mount the, what is this called? Like the latch and stuff like that. But these are details. Now we are dealing with the body. So in this episode, I think we should go back to this area where we actually started many moons ago. And I dug deep down there, and it's a mess. But luckily we have Fender. It's in that box. We're gonna take it out and we will see, but I believe it goes somewhere to here and here, so we will see how far that goes. But maybe since we're gonna have to weld somewhere, maybe we should just go far and cut it like this, so we have straight lines, we don't have those things, and we can also open bigger area here so we can work easier on the layers underneath. At the time when we ordered the fenders, I couldn't find cheap rockers. They were like over 250 American, which was stupidly expensive for me. But now actually most motors offers them for, I think, about 90 bucks, 90 something, which is a much better price. So, and we were just debating with Nick that maybe we should order them, and they come from here. This is part of the rocker, so it comes like this and all the way down, and it goes inside the door jamb all the way to here. But we don't need this, so we might, I don't want to take apart the whole car to change the rocker. So even if we order them, I think we're gonna cut the new rockers somewhere here and these ones here, and make them and make a joint here. We will see, but that also is gonna help us for the front end. Nick, can you take out the fender, please? Yeah, because you see here the rocker is also gone, so it's not that hard to repair that. But if we can buy one rocker complete, that's gonna save us trouble. So maybe that's what we're gonna do. Most motors also offers a repair panel for the fenders at the bottom here. Maybe we should get those as well. Anyways, let's pull out the fenders and see where we should cut this, so we can open a little bit bigger area here. Okay, so here are our fenders. This is the left one, and this is the right one. And I'm not really happy with them, to be honest, because of this shape here. You see how it is not smooth. And over here, I don't know if you can see it, but there's also like a dent. The other one looks better. Like this one is nice and smooth here. And where's this other part? Here. That one is like, has like a sharp crease here and sharp crease down here. Like they're not the best. But we're gonna, before we weld them in, we're gonna have to fix that, smoothen it somehow, because that's gonna require a lot of bond to fill here, and that's gonna be too high here. That's what happens with reproduction parts. Anyways, so let me show you how it goes. Also here, from the pressing, look, it looks horrible. All these creases and stuff, but we're not gonna use this because here ours is solid, so we're just gonna cut it maybe here half an inch, right where this bend is, and we're gonna that's where we're gonna weld it. But that's how it goes. So we have the entire wheel arch, which we don't need. And here also, there's no curve here. This is even deep, and this is like smooth. Oh my god. And this needs to come out. It does come out, but it's popping like it's oil canning. So to be honest, we might just strip here the body filler, because there's a little bit of body filler here, and see how good the metal is. And we're not gonna go that far up. We're gonna just stop it here somewhere. And here, because the wheel arch, even inside the inner wheel well, feels good from this point to the left. So we're gonna maybe cut it here, here, and here. Okay, so I marked where we think we should cut it. Initially, I was thinking to cut it straight line here, but then I changed my mind because, like I said, this part here, I don't think you can see it very well in the camera, but this right here is pushed in. So if by cutting it this way, I'm gonna rely more on this part here to keep this part up, like out, because it's oil canning here. So yeah, why not? Let's go ahead and cut it, like on the lower line, not this, the lower, and here. That gives us a little bit more room to work here. And maybe we're gonna cut this here because the new rocker comes with it. So that's where we're gonna cut the new rocker too. So we have more room to here. And then we might even cut this off a little bit wider so we can go in under, because here inside we also have lots of repairs that right now we can't reach. But if we take the rocker off, if we take this part off and keep it, we're gonna put this back later, but that's gonna give us access to the bottom. Maybe next we should cut the fender too, to match it with this. For now, we're not gonna cut it exact. We're gonna cut it maybe an 3/4 inch higher, the fender, I mean, so we can overlap them and put some clickers to hold them in place, match the door gap and everything. And then we will know that we have the exact position of the fender, and we can put it on and off all the time without losing its position. And of course, we're gonna weld it only after we repair everything underneath. Now let's mark the fender. So we wanna cut it here. That's a little bit overlapping. We'll see how high. But for this height here, I think I first need to cut it here so I can mark this. Actually, I can do this, right? Supposedly, this should be the same height, so we want to cut this a little bit higher. And then here, I'm just going to take a very rough measurement. So that's where the cut is currently, so we want to go a little bit higher, so we're gonna cut it there. You see what I'm talking about, guys? Look how far down it is. And here we have a perfectly straight line, but we're gonna fix it. Thank you. Good job.
Thank you.
All right. I think here, I'm not gonna go all the way down like I did there. I'm gonna stop it higher, and there we're gonna cut it higher too. Let's see how it matches. Okay. It's really bad. This part is keeping it out. How it is not a straight line. It seems like a thick metal, but super soft. Now also we have a, you know what, I'm gonna get rid of a little bit of this, or I'm just gonna bend it in for now. Now at least this curve matches pretty well. Now it's out here, it's overlapping the other metal, so that's why it's not, but this curve matches and this curve matches, so that's good.
And the line too.
And the line matches. This is where we have an issue. So I guess for now, we're gonna clamp it here and we're gonna put a clicko here. And we're gonna try to work this part to go in. Actually, before we do the clicko up there, we're gonna have to make them not overlap on this side here. When they don't overlap, the panel is gonna move by the thickness of the metal in this direction, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So we're gonna drill a hole through both layers of metal, and this will keep them together. And then always when we take it out and put it back in, if we match these two holes on the two layers of metal, it's gonna be positioned in the exact same position that we had the first time. But if we drill the hole now, and then we cut one of the two layers here so they don't overlap, it's gonna move and the two holes are not gonna match anymore.
Yeah.
So that's why we're gonna cut one of the layers here.
The paint's melting.
Yeah, normal. So I'm not worried about this cut here because it's gonna be cut higher anyways. Right now we're just leaving the two overlapping so it's easier to position it and hold it in place, but at the end before we weld it, we're gonna cut it and we're gonna butt weld them. We're not gonna overlap them. So now it's good, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so now...
Is everything else good?
We'll see. We have to start clamping it from somewhere. Okay.
And so, like, the left side is a tiny bit lower.
But it's gonna come in. Later when it comes in.
Yeah, it's good, it's good.
Okay, so now this matches here. And because I'm afraid that the clamp might move, I'm gonna put a clicko here as well, even though this rocker is gonna be cut.
You know what we never checked? This at the bottom, how it's gonna be.
Yeah. It's not finished. You can always keep it with clamps, but every time you take it off and then put it on again, you're not sure if you're putting it in the same position. But with Klikus, you are sure that this is the exact same position. Okay. So now let's see. We can force it down. We can force it and weld it, but the problem is that this metal is going to pull this way, that metal is going to pull that way, and it's not going to be perfect. We want this, before we start welding, we want this line to match perfectly this line. So I think that somewhere here we need to curve this in.
Yeah.
Because that's the problem right now, that this flange here underneath is bent in such a way that it's pulling it out here. So if we shrink this flange a little bit right here, that's gonna bring the whole metal down here. I think this bend here is what gives us troubles.
But isn't all of that bending and shrinking and stretching gonna mess up what we did with the Klikus?
No. The Klikus are gonna hold it here. We want this to go down, right? We want it to go that way. In order to go that way, this flange now is holding it up. It can't, this cannot go down because this flange is holding it. If this flange goes like this a little bit, we shrink one end, it's gonna go like this, and that's gonna bring this part and this part down.
Okay.
So it's gonna make this curve curved because now it's a straight line almost.
Okay.
Now we can take it off the Klikus and it's gonna come back to the same place after. So we said we want to shrink right here where this little dent is. So here. See? When I'm pressing on the pedal, look here. See how it's going in?
Yeah.
They go. Okay, let's see how far we are. All right, that's much better, but we need a little bit more right here. That's it. And now we have a curved line here because before it was a straight line. Okay, you see that's so much better now. But now here, this is a straight line up where it needs to go down and then up. You see this curve here doesn't exist here. How easy it is now to put it in the same exact position. Now this is much better here, matching pretty well. So the only problem is here now. Need to go down and then up. Wow, it's amazing. What? Why is it so soft? This metal. Like I'm bending everything with my fingers. Okay, I think that's how we're gonna leave it for now. We're gonna adjust it perfectly when the time comes to weld it. For now, let's put two more Klikus here. Okay. You can imagine now that the lower metal is going somewhere here and somewhere here, right? So you can put it somewhere in the corner here. Push all the way in. Yeah, that's it. So that looks good, except here at the bottom. Let me actually show you. Maybe we should just put the fender on top and forget about the bottom. Unfortunately, that's how many shops do repairs. They would change the whole panel outside. They would put a piece of metal here, do the same there. Put the fender, change the outside of the fender, and everything inside, they would just leave it like this. But that's not what we're gonna do. So anyway, that's what I'm talking about here. You see, they they didn't make a flange to go down and match the flange of the match this flange. Also here they made such a sharp turn, it needs to be like this, something like that. But look what they did here, they just bent it. So we have to unbend this, and then with the shrinker we're gonna make nice and smooth curve here. But at least we have the outer metal now matching with the door, nice door gap. Let's see it. I never checked this, I never checked here. Yeah, that's perfect. So that's gonna be at the end, we're gonna, when we're welding the fender, we're gonna have to push here in or out or whatever, we have to match this gap nicely so we have the same height of the fender with the door, because right now here you see it's a little bit higher, so it needs to go in, but that we're gonna adjust at the end. And actually this part of the fender is too long, because the old one was ending somewhere here. The sills or the rockers, they have a step here, and we're gonna cut this fender here when we have the rocker installed, so we can figure out exactly where to cut it. I'm talking about a step like this. We have the same step on the rocker at the back. And once we cut it here, when we know where to cut it, we're gonna cut it a little bit longer, and we're gonna bend the edge in. And it's gonna be just like the GT6, for example, right here, has the same thing, where the rocker panel, in this case, overlaps this panel, but the rocker panel has a little bit of a bend in, so it's nice overlap. All right, so now that we have the outer metal fitted perfectly, we know exactly where it goes, we can use it as a guide to fix the wheel arch and everything that is inside here. So we're gonna start digging deeper and deeper until we reach the last layer and repair them all from inside out. But we're gonna start doing that in the next episode, because this video is gonna become way too long if we continue. We have lots of work inside here. So thank you for keeping us company in the garage. I hope you enjoyed this restoration, and if you like this video, you might check our other videos on mostly Triumphs that we restore. You might like those as well. So thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for commenting and subscribing. Thanks for sharing. Thanks for supporting the channel, and we will see you in the next one. Bye.
Bye.